This question is asking us to draw the full structural formulas and give the systematic UPAC names of each of the following compounds. Now for these compounds shown here, we're given condensed structural formulas. So we have to draw the full structural formulas. So we have to expand them, draw them out, show the bonds, show as much detail as we can. So in my head, the trick I have is to always think of every carbon needing four bonds. So if we look at this part A and we read through it from left to right, we start off with a carbon. So I'm just going to draw a single carbon. So that's this carbon accounted for. Now it has to have four bonds. So I'm going to look at what's next to it. There's three hydrogens. That will be three of its four bonds. Three hydrogens around it. There we go. Then the next thing is a carbon, so it's the fourth bond. So it's that carbon done with four bonds. Now this next carbon has to have four bonds as well. So what's bonded to it? So we have a hydrogen after it, so there's a hydrogen. And we have a bracket. That's another thing bonded to it. And what's in this bracket is a methyl group. So that is not part of the chain. That bracket is part of this second carbon's four bonds. Next, we have to fill in the last bond on this carbon, and it's the next carbon. And then it has three hydrogens on to fill its four bonds up, and that's our condensed structural formula complete. Our condensed structural formula shown as a full structural formula. And then we have to name it. So if we go to name it, we know its parent alkane, because the carbon chain, the longest chain, is three carbons long. We know that the parent alkane is propane. And as well, those carbons are all singly bonded, so it's an alkane. Now, if we look for any branches, we'll see that there's a branch here. And carbons 1, 2, and 3 numbered. That methyl group there is on the second carbon. So we have two methyl propane. Now for part B, again, we're starting on the left and working our way across. So first we have a carbon with three hydrogens on it. So a carbon with three hydrogens. Then we have our next carbon. Now in that carbon we have two hydrogens. And then we have the next carbon. Then on that we have two hydrogens. Then we have the next carbon with a hydrogen. And what goes below it is CH3, a methyl group. And then we have the next carbon and three hydrogens around it. So that's our full structural formula. We need to name this. So to name it, again, identify the longest carbon chain. That's it there. And we see that it's 5 carbons long, all singly bonded. So it's pentane. But that's not us finished, because we have to account for the branches. So to do that, I need to number the carbons. And we should be able to recognize around now that because my branch... Because my branch is here, that I should number the carbons in this direction. So that the branch is on carbon 2, rather than on carbon 4, if I'd have numbered them the wrong way, the other way around, because we want to have the smallest possible numbers. So we have a methyl group on carbon 2. That means it is 2-methyl pentane. That is our compound. Now for part C here. So it's just slightly longer, but it's the same thing really. So we start off with a carbon and three hydrogens. So I have a carbon with three hydrogens around it. That's this one. Now I have a carbon with two hydrogens, followed by a carbon with a hydrogen and a CH3. So that methyl group there, followed by a carbon with a hydrogen and a CH3 again, followed by a carbon and three hydrogens. So that's my full structural formula. Now I need to name it. So longest unbroken chain of carbons is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons long. So it's pent, and because they're singly bonded to each other, it's ane. So pentane is my parent molecule. I'm going to number my carbons to give me the smallest branch numbers, because my branches are here and here. I'm going to start numbering from this end, because I'll have the numbers now 2 and 3 for my branches, whereas if I went the other direction, I'd have had 3 and 4, which are larger numbers, and I don't want that. So back to naming, I have 2 methyl groups, one on the second carbon, one on the third carbon. Because I have 2 methyl groups, I have dimethyl in my name, and they're on the second and third carbons. That's the name finished. So for part D, we're going to need to draw its full structural formula. So it begins with a carbon with 3 hydrogens around it. Carbon with 3 hydrogens, then a carbon with a hydrogen and a CH3, and then a carbon with a hydrogen with a CH3, and then a carbon with 3 hydrogens to finish us off. So now to name this molecule, I need to identify the longest carbon chain there, as highlighted. And because that longest carbon chain is 4 carbons long, it's bute. And because they're all singly bonded to each other, it's butane. So butane there is our parent alkane. Now I need to identify and name my branches and locate them as well. So these are my branch groups here. I have 2 methyl groups. And they are on carbons. Now, in this compound, it doesn't actually matter which direction I number them in, because no matter what side we go from, they'll always be carbons 2 and 3. Okay? So we have 2 methyl groups. That means my name gets to have dimethyl in it. Di, because there's 2 of them. So dimethyl butane even, and they're on the second and third carbons. So that's the UPAC name for part D, 2,3 dimethyl butane. Now for part E. Part E is written slightly differently. So we're going to just take it bit by bit. So first of all, we have CH3. That's C with 3 H's around it, as normal. Nothing unusual there. But then we have this CH2 with a 5 outside. So we have 5 of them. So let's just see what the CH2 looks like when we put it in. So if I put in a carbon with 2 hydrogens, that's what I'm doing. I'm adding that in. And it wants me to add 5 of them. So I've added 1 in, so I'll add another 4. So it's the second CH2, the third CH2, the fourth CH2, and the fifth CH2, and then finally a C with 3 H's to finish us off. Okay, so to name it, longest unbroken carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbons in length. So that means it's hept. And because they're all singly bonded, ane, heptane. And if we look at this hydrocarbon, we see that we have no branching happening. So heptane is just the name. It's a normal straight chain alkane. No branches, that's us finished. So the last one, part F. We're going to start by drawing the full structural formula. So I have a carbon with three hydrogens around it. Then I have a carbon with two CH3s. So a CH3 above and a CH3 below. That looks like an O, so I'm going to change it to a C. Then we have a C with two H's. Then we have a carbon with a hydrogen, a C with a H, and with a CH3. And then a C with three H's to finish us off. So what we need to do is name it now. And to name it, again, longest unbroken chain of carbons. That's the longest one. There's actually one, two, three, four different ways you could have highlighted the longest chain of carbons. And no matter which way you would have done it, you would have still gotten the same UPAC name. So don't worry if you didn't get it exactly the way I got it. Just check to see if the rest is correct, see if your name at the end is right. So because there are five carbons in that longest chain, our prefix is going to be pent for our parent alkane. And all single bonds, so it's an alkane, ends in ane, pentane. Now we need to identify our branches. So there's a branch, there's a branch, and there's a branch, and they're all methyls. So I will have trimethyl in my name, but I need my numbers. So if I'm going to number my parent alkane, I want a number from the direction that gives me the lowest possible numbers. Now, if I number this from right to left, the chain, the branches will be on carbons 2, 4, and 4. If I number it from left to right, my branches will be on carbons 2, 2, and 4. So 2, 2, and 4 are the lower numbers, so that's the direction I'm going to use. I'm going to go from left to right. And go back to my naming now. So because I have three methyl groups, I have trimethyl in my name. And where are my branches? They're on 2, 2, and 4. 2, 2, 4, trimethyl pentane. And as we get further into this topic, we're going to see heptane and 2,2,4 trimethyl pentane again, because they're very important compounds when we're talking about octane numbers.